Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and Assalamu alaikum. I'm Dr. Ziam Shahid and I welcome you to my YouTube channel. In this channel, I make medical educational videos, particularly focusing on OSCE skill stations. If you haven't already subscribed my channel, kindly do subscribe for upcoming videos on gynecology and obstetrics, pediatrics, medicine, surgery and more. In today's video, we will discuss how to take obstetric and gynecological history, and in upcoming video I will give you some examples of written histories of patient with GDM, pregnancy induced hypertension, post op patient, etc., and how to present the history to the examiner, how to summarize it and give its diagnosis. After watching this video, please watch part 2. So let's start with obstetric and gynecological history taking. Taking a history and performing obstetric examination are different compared with the history and examination in other specialties. The main difference is that the patient is normally a healthy woman undergoing normal life event. When meeting a patient for the first time, always introduce yourself. Tell the patient who you are and why have you come to see them. Make sure that the patient is seated comfortably. Some women will wish another person to be present even just to take a history, and this wish should be respected. So we will start with the patient's profile. In the patient profile, we will ask the name of the patient, her age, her address, whether her marriage was within family with her cousin. This is called consanguinity. Her profession, if she is a working woman. How long is she married? Date of admission to the hospital, mode of admission, whether she came in emergency or she came in OPD and then she was admitted. Gravidity, which refers to the total number of times she has been pregnant, irrespective of the result of the pregnancy. So if she is pregnant right now and she already has 2 children, she will be gravida 3. Parity, which refers to total number of deliveries after the age of viability. The age of viability differs in different countries. Mostly it is around 24 weeks. And LMP. All of this will be included in the patient's profile. The next step is presenting complaint, which is not very different in other specialties. If she has some specific complaint, we will ask the details, like origin, duration and progress of the presenting complaint, whether she is already diagnosed, whether she had already tests performed, and treatment she is already taking. In OBS history, always ask for fetal movements, bleeding per vaginum, abdominal pain and any leaking fluids vaginally in the presenting complaint section. Also ask gravidity and parity within presenting complaint section. If you have already asked her, you should not repeat it, but this is included in presenting complaint section. The third part is history of presenting complaint. In history of presenting complaint, firstly you should ask LMP, then you should calculate her EDD by Neagle's rule. The Neagle's rule I have already taught in my previous video. The link would be given somewhere above. We will ask the gestational age, whether her pregnancy was planned or unplanned, whether it was spontaneous or induced, and how pregnancy was confirmed. Mostly the pregnancy is confirmed by urine pregnancy test done at home or at hospital. And then we will ask about her booking date, which refers to first time she went to hospital after she had symptoms, after she expected to be pregnant. Then we will start the obstetric history trimester wise. The first trimester means first 3 months of the pregnancy. We will ask about her LMP, method of confirmation, her booking date, dating scan done, which is normally around 8 to 12 weeks, and screening tests done like full blood count, blood grouping, urinary and random sugar. We will calculate her BMI, infectious screening, and infection screening for syphilis. We'll do VDRL. We'll do infectious screen of HIV, hepatitis B and C, and husband's MCV to check for thalassemia trait. Then we will ask her questions about vaccination, like tetanus, folic acid, is she already taking it or not, hyperemesis, did she felt fever, should she had any bleeding, or did she felt any pain during her first trimester. We will ask whether her blood pressure was normal or raised or decreased during her first trimester, and ask her what other drugs did she took during her first trimester. And lastly, we will ask if she had any rash in any part of her body during the first trimester. In the second trimester, we will start with the fetal movements. Then we will ask her about her anamnesis scan, which is around usually 18th to 20th week. We will ask, did she take any supplements of calcium, vitamins, vitamin D and iron, and about her tetanus vaccination status, and NTD, folic acid, glucose tolerance test, fever, rash, urinary, blood pressure, and screening of hepatitis B and C. In the third trimester, we will ask whether she had already discussed her mode of delivery with the doctors. We will ask NSS, the growth of the baby. We will ask her whether she is taking iron, whether she has already given glucose tolerance test, and what was its result. We will ask her about her blood pressure and the tetanus prophylaxis. Tetanus, according to WHO, is given in 3 shots. The first dose is given as soon as pregnancy is detected. The second dose, 4 weeks after the first dose. And the third dose, 6 months after the second dose, to provide full protection for 5 years. Then we will ask her about her previous obstetric history. Firstly, we'll start off her children which were born at term or after 24 weeks, which is age of viability. We will ask about their gestational age. Did she had any preterm labor during each of the children? We will ask about mode of delivery of each of the children, whether it was normal vaginal delivery, instrumental delivery, and lower segment cesarean section. We will ask about the gender, birth weight of the babies. And we will ask her about the complications which she might have faced during her first pregnancies. And in complications, we will ask her about gestation diabetes mellitus, pregnancy-induced hypertension, intrapartum hemorrhage, postpartum hemorrhage, depression, manual removal of placenta, and infections. We will ask her that whether her children are alive or deceased. If the children are alive, we will ask her about the condition at birth and the present condition. And if they are dead, we will ask at what age they died and what was the cause. We will ask planned or whether the previous children were planned and unplanned, and spontaneous or induction was done for pregnancy. The second part of previous ops history is for the children who were born less than 24 weeks. we will ask about the gestational age, and if they were miscarried, what was the cause, and outcome or management of the miscarriage, like did she had DNC. We will ask her about ectopic pregnancies, if she had any, and in ectopic pregnancies, we will ask her about the site and management which she underwent. Then we'll start the gynecological history. In the gynecological history, firstly we'll ask her if she felt amenorrhea previously. Did she had any vaginal bleeding? And in vaginal bleeding, we'll ask her about intermenstrual bleeding, postcoital bleeding, and postmenopausal bleeding. We will ask her about heavy menstrual bleeding, which is relative. So we will ask, like, did she had bleeding which was more than normal? And if she replies in positive, we will ask some details of HMB, heavy menstrual bleeding. And in that, we will ask her what clothes did she used during that time? What was the spillover of cloth on bed sheets? And how many times the clothing was changed. Then we will ask any vaginal discharge, if she had any, and if she had, we'll ask her about the color, consistency, amount and smell of the discharge. Then we'll ask about the previous episodes of pelvic inflammatory diseases, any vulvar or anal itching, rash or any skin abnormality did she had any previously, and the last date of cervical smear. And lastly, we'll ask her about any previous gynecological surgery, like in vitro fertilization or donor sperm or egg. However, legally you should not ask, legally you should not write down in notes that pregnancy is conceived in vitro fertilization or donor egg or sperm was used, unless you have the written permission from the patient. Then we'll start the menstrual history. Firstly, we'll ask her about the menarche, whether her menstruation are regular or irregular, frequency, oligomenorrhea and polymenorrhagia. We'll ask her about the frequency of the menstrual cycle, and then we'll obviously find out whether she had oligomenorrhea or polymenorrhagia. The duration of bleeding, how many days during the month did she bled? The volume of the bleeding, clots, if there was there were present or not, dysmenorrhea or dyspareunia, and heavy menstrual bleeding, if she had. We'll repeat the same questions like we did previously. Then we'll start the past medical history. In the past medical history, we will focus on diabetes mellitus, hypertension, renal diseases, epilepsy, venothrombus thromboembolism, asthma or shortness of breath, if she felt, cardiac diseases, bleeding disorders, hepatitis, STDs, HIV, pap smear if she when she had last, connective tissue diseases, myasthenia gravis, previous gynecological problem if she came to the hospital for those problem, or did she just take home medications, any previous surgeries, and allergies if she had any. Then we'll start the drug history, and in the drug history we'll name we'll ask about the names, frequencies and routes of the drugs taken, whether the drugs were over-the-counter pills, oral contraceptive pills, hormone replacement therapy, folic acids or vitamins, did she take drugs due to allergies, or herbal or homeopathic medicines. Then we'll start the family history, and in the family history, the important areas are a maternal history of first degree relatives, the maternal history of first degree relatives, the siblings of the mother and parents of the mother. With these group of people, if they had diabetes, thromboembolic disease, hypertension or preeclampsia, serious psychiatric disorders, which will increase the risk of puerperal psychosis. If breast, ovarian or endometrial cancer is present in the family. And lastly, we'll ask the family history of the babies with congenital abnormality and genetic problems such as hemoglobinopathies. We'll start the social history by asking the husband's profession, any weight changes during or after the pregnancy or before the pregnancy, home situation of the patient. In home situation, we'll focus on domestic abuse. This is a sensitive topic. Then we'll start, then we will ask the smoking, alcohol or drug intake of the patient. Smoking causes reduction in birth weight in a dose dependent way. It also increases the risk of miscarriage, stillbirth and neonatal death. We'll ask about the diet and exercise of the patient. And then we will start the systemic history by focusing on the system relating to the presenting complaint. After this history, you should be able to just be confident, and I will suggest you to take screenshots or write these points down and try to memorize them, and inshallah you will be golden. And then in the next video, I'll give you examples with a patient suffering from gestational diabetes mellitus, pregnancy induced hypertension or post-op patients.